morning, students. As you know, today we will start the topic reproduction in animals. So let's give some introductory part about reproduction. What is reproduction? As you know, only those living organisms will survive in this society or the earth whose organisms are having large number of same individuals, and these individuals can be produced by their parents by the process of reproduction. So what is reproduction? Reproduction is done by the parents to produce new individuals of the same species. That's called reproduction. Now there are few modes of reproduction as well. We can categorize these modes into two categories, that is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In case of asexual reproduction, only one parent is required. One parent is required for doing this type of reproduction. That's called asexual reproduction. But in case of sexual reproduction, we need two parents. That's one is male and another one is female. And in this reproduction, there is a main process which takes place, that's called fertilization, in which there is a formation of zygote when sperms, it's also called gametes. It also called gametes when strikes in the ovum. They fuse together and they produce a zygote, which develops inside an embryo. And this is the first stage in the process of reproduction. So we categorize the reproduction into two categories, that is asexual reproduction, in which only one parent is required, and sexual reproduction, in which only we need two parents, one female and another one is male. After that, there is another topic, it's called fertilization. Now fertilization is also of two types. One is internal fertilization and another one is external fertilization. In case of internal fertilization, in which the babies dwell inside that particular organisms and they give birth as the young ones, that's called internal fertilization. And external, in which the organisms lay eggs and the rest of the parts will grow inside that particular shell outside the body, that's called external fertilization. In internal fertilization, there are cows, humans, animals, which give birth to the young ones. And in case of external fertilization, there is hens, snakes, tortoise, which lay eggs and doing reproduction. Next topic is viviparous and oviparous animals. As we know, viviparous animals are those animals in which they give birth to their young ones, like cows, humans, animals. And oviparous animals are those animals which lay eggs in the process of reproduction. So this is the main topics in the first lecture, that is reproduction, modes of reproduction, that is asexual and sexual reproduction, fertilization, that is internal and external fertilization. And on the basis of fertilization, we will categorize the animals into two parts, that is viviparous and oviparous animals. After this, we will discuss about some modes of asexual reproduction. Now, as you know, there are few types of asexual reproduction, like fragmentation, budding, bind fission, and regeneration. These are the few other types of asexual reproduction: fragmentation, budding, bind fission, and regeneration. But in this chapter, we will discuss about budding and bind fission. Now let's start with the topic of binary fission. What is binary fission? So binary fission is a process in which a body is split into two parts and they will produce the same individual. Like there is a single part, this is a small organism, and with the passage of time this will split into two parts. It's called binary fission. Fission means splitting. It splits into two parts, which results in the reproduction of two same individuals by their parents. And this is done under the reproduction of asexual reproduction. This is done under the category of asexual reproduction. And the another one is, that is budding. Now what is budding? Budding is basically done in Hydra. Hydra is also organism. It is done in Hydra. What does Hydra do? Hydra contains, like this is the structure, it contains some tentacles on the upper part of the body. Like these are the tentacles. A new body will grow on this parent body. A new body will grow on this parent body, and with the passage of time this body detaches itself, means it separates itself from the parent body, resulting in the formation of a new Hydra, which is same properties and same qualities as the parent body. This is a process called budding, and this is also under the category of asexual reproduction. So I will recapitulate again. In this topic, we will revise or we will recapture again what is reproduction. Reproduction is the production of the same individuals by their parents. That's called reproduction. And it is under of two categories, that is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. After that, we will cover about the various types of animals depending on the type of fertilization they would undergo. That's viviparous and oviparous. Viviparous are those in which there is internal fertilization and they will give birth to the young ones. In oviparous, they will give birth to the, they lay eggs, and this is under the category of internal fertilization. And there is some categories of asexual reproduction, that is fragmentation, budding, binary fission, regeneration. But in this chapter, we will discuss about budding and binary fission. In binary fission, there is a splitting of the cell into two individuals having same quality. But in budding, it takes place mainly in Hydra, which having tentacles on the upper part, and the new Hydra particle will develop on the parent body and it gets separated by itself after some interval, and this is how new Hydra will develop. This is it for the topic reproduction and its modes. Thank you.